the core banking function.
Yes,
if
which
it
is
happens to be in 20, if you're not giving to the SMEs, the real sector to grow, if you're giving to some other persons who were not particularly led into the real sector, you're bound to have problems in the long run.
No, you need to understand also that banks take from the place of the little to the place of the surplus. Okay, from place of the surplus to the place that is demanded. Most people who are looking for the big ticket transactions are the big boys, the oil and gas, the power. And so they invested.
But we know that the SMEs drive economy. If people say we can't access long-term loans in Nigerian banks, so how do you expect to see us begin to earn Forex?
But a lot of the banks are heading, and you know, I even know the banks who are training SMEs. There's a lot going on in that regard.
Are they now giving out long-term loans?
No, most bank staffs are closed.
They're
closed, and it's not unconnected with the fact that the place don't even know what is going on.
The banks don't.
Listen, guys, the business, capital market, money market does not in any way allow for uncertainty. Uncertainty is what makes them. Let's understand first of all.
We have uncertainties in the country. Yes. Is that what you're saying?
Excuse me.
We have uncertainty.
No, you have certainty, right? Do you have certainty?
You don't think the policies are certain enough?
No. I'm asking you. You asked me. And I'm supposed to answer the questions. All right. If you have certainty, you know, you will see the, you know, the Naira is at 402 or 300 and something. The inflow should be coming. The money should be coming in for the investment. Why are they holding in the wings? You know, it's not exactly what you say.
What would you do if you were a CBN governor?
I'm not the CBN governor, so I won't answer your question. I'm not the CBN governor.
You wouldn't come up with a solution?
Mm-hmm.
You said they should be creative.
Yeah, that's all they should
give
be creative.
An example.
Listen, I'm not saying the CBN is not doing their bit. You asked me about the FX, and I told you clearly that
the
challenge, I believe, is strongly you've pulled the carpet from the banks, coupled with the fall in oil and gas prices, plus all other issues that are happening. So the banks are woozy. So if you return back the carpet, at least one of the things that is making them woozy is has been returned.
Well, will that mean looking the other way?
No. Maybe I need to be a little bit there. If, for instance, government says, you know what, the TSA we pulled out so quickly, we want to begin to find a way to bring it, to allow you. Mm. This issue of FS will not happen because it will have been the fact that banks are holding the monies of the MDAs and ministries.
Okay.
Officially.
All right. We'll be back in a minute. Don't go away. Let me move you to this other matter. I know that there's been some response to it. That reported request of the president to have these powers to fix the economy. You think that should happen?
Okay. He doesn't need any economic power to recalibrate the economy, doesn't. Some of these things are within executive administrative powers. If the way it is going with the National Assembly, it would create another delay. He just does not need.
Why do you think that even came up in the first place?
He doesn't need any economy. Jamalini, he doesn't need. That's his work. You don't need to do a national conference again to recalibrate the economy. There are things, touch points you will do. The system will recalibrate. And they know it.
Yeah, they know it, but they're not willing to do it. Is that what you're saying?
You know, yeah, let me tell you something. Every time a government asks for such powers, go and check it out. It's normally what happens in very civil, very elevated environments. They'll face it and they will say, give me those powers. It happened in the US when the 2007-2008. If you go there now, you're going to see this power. Somebody is going to interpret it. It will go political. It will go various ways, and you will not be able to track it. So I think the government, the presidency, and the government now have capacities within themselves to be able to reflate the system. There are things they need to do to reflate the system. The people need to begin to feel the resources. And one of them, I said, is the bank. You can't do it without working with the banks. They need to reflect. They need to allow the banks to work, to function in conjunction, and the capital budget begin to invest, begin to spend your way. You spend your way out of a recession.
But instead of they've been pumping more funds, and that is just the processes. Once that is done, the economy will begin to feel the impact.
Okay, let's keep waiting. Thank you, Putin.
Pascal Adigwe is a business and financial analyst. Thank you for coming on this morning.
Thank you.
Well, that's it also today on the program. We thank you for watching. We'll be back tomorrow. I'm Chamberlain Osa.
I'm Nell Taigwe. Thank you for watching.
Well, thank you so much. I still can't, you know, forget that instance of the little girl playing on the floor after she's been warned not to. Well, thank you. Maokbe Ogun.
Goodbye.